I came from a bad background, basically my own background. My pop, I had a good upbringing from my mom's and pops. I chose to step off and do my own thing. And me doing my own thing, that led me down the road to doing drugs. Back then, that's when crack came out. And I can openly, honestly admit I was one of those that got hooked on it, okay? I'm not ashamed of it. It is what it is. It's part of life.
Were you in a tough neighborhood or something?
Actually, I was running with some pretty tough characters.
I know, but how did you get associated with them?
We was all living in the same
That's
group
what I was
at the
asking.
Time.
You lived in a kind of a crime-infested area?
Oh, no, the area wasn't crime-infested at the time.
Well, how do you get thugs? Because that's the only place I know you get them from is another, unless they want to be thugs.
I mean, that's what it was,
you
know.
You want to be.
He was a wannabe young.
All right, that's what I'm wondering. You know, if you got two parents in the household, then it becomes peer pressure. And the community dictates what that peer pressure is going to be. If you're in a poor and drug and crime-infested area, the peer pressure is to be on drugs, selling drugs, or engaged in criminal activity, because that's the type of pressure if you're in an impoverished area. If you're in a two-parent household area, then the peer pressure is typically to excel, to be motivated in school, to be in sports, to have fun regularly on the street, playing basketball under the street lights, not worrying about getting shot or getting robbed or none of the other things that you have to when you live in a poor and drug-infested community.